Here in this spot, James Schneider built the first hotel in 1895, and it sat here just a little bit on their side of the creek, I believe. He had the hotel, and of course the only way you could get up here was by boat from Apgar. You came up on Lake McDonald to this area. There were no roads. I think Deidre said it was in 1917 when they finally got up here to Lake McDonald with the roads. So it was boats up to this point. In 1906, a man by the name of John Lewis bought the hotel from James Schneider. And he ran it in 1910 when the park was created. He was able to get the Park Service to allow him to build some private little small cabins that he had here for a couple of years. But with the Great Northern coming in, with all the, you know, nine locations of the chalets and the two big hotels, Mini Glacier and Glacier Park Lodge, he could see that, you know, he probably needed another hotel over on this side because they're all converging on this area. And since he owned the land here, he decided to build a major hotel here. So he went over in 1911 to Kirkland Cutter and saw his work on rustic arts and crafts, whatever you want to call it, architecture, and said, you know, we want something like that here. And so he hired Kirkland Cutter at that time to design a hotel that was in 1912, and then by 1913 they started construction, and was finished in 1914 when they actually opened. So that's what is it. But the interesting thing is this is the front of the hotel, because you came up on the boat, and all these trees were in here growing up. It was, you could see right through here, and there's a beautiful shot of this is the main entrance to the hotel. The by the time the automobiles came in, and after 1917, and of course when the, going by the 1930s when they're going to the sun, it really had changed. People started coming in the back, and so in the 1980s, the Park Service redeveloped this whole area, making it more of a patio job in this area, like you see right here where we're all sitting, and then put really the parking and the main entrances into the back of the hotel. It wasn't named after me.
Did I get it in?
Yeah. Did give me an in. But anyway, Kirkland Cutter, you know, he had this whole rustic style, of course, what we call now the Park Service with all the railroads, but a lot of rustic architecture all the way through the West, and which I have been fortunate to have worked on many of the hotels and all the different parks. But anyway, he designed this, and of course he had that whole experience of Swiss architecture. He really liked that style, and then made it compatible with what you see here within the park. And so you see some of the things like stucco that was used with timbers to define areas, that, you know, part of that whole Swiss style, that it wasn't just all timbers, there was other materials too. And as you go to the inside, what was nice about all these hotels, all the way through here, including all the great Northern hotels, or in Yellowstone with the Northern Pacific, or all the way down into the Grand Canyon, is that the whole idea was to bring people out to experience the wilderness. But if you looked at the photos of people going to the chalets and stuff, they had suits on and ties and dresses, you know, women's dresses. And everybody dressed up for but anyway, they brought them to the hotels here, and of course it was quite an experience. But what was neat about it, which you'll see in here is the other hotels, is that they also brought the outside to the inside. So you see the nice timber work, the trees, like at Glacier Park, you see all that nice tall 60-foot high fir trees with the little Doric capitals on top that was made part of that hotel. But they brought that in on the inside, and then plus they brought in things like the old hickory furniture, what am I trying to say?
The bentwoods?
And all the bentwood chairs, and just all that is part of that whole experience of that. You not only experience the outside, but you get experienced it on the inside too, and that's what really people like.